Hello everyone. Today we're going to explore what's new with the home screen on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now I'm not going to be showing anything with Apple AI. This is just straight iOS 18. This has nothing to do with the AI. Also, before we dive into today's video, if you find this video helpful, make sure to watch till the end. I'll share a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in bringing you these videos. All right, let's get started. The first thing we're going to look at is flexible app icon placement. What do I mean by that? Well, basically what we can do is we can now rearrange our apps basically anywhere we want. Let's take a look at this. Let's go over to my iPhone. So I'm looking at my iPhone here. We all know how it works to move our apps. We just place or tap and hold anywhere where there's no apps. So I tap and hold. They start going into jiggle mode, and then all I have to do is just move them. But when I move them, what it does is it always rearranges our apps to go into the upper left-hand corner. So basically, we cannot leave a blank spot up here. Or maybe what you want to do is you want to leave a blank spot over here. Well, this is what we can now do with flexible app icons. Essentially, all we have to do is just move an app anywhere we want. So let's just go and move the camera app down here and watch what happens when I do that. So now I just tap and hold to get into that jiggle mode again. And then I just drag it down. And you can see that it just moved it down. That's all we have to do. Let's go ahead and do that with the passwords app. Move it down. I just drag it down and it moves it down. Now when I tap on it again, we can see that I move those down. You're really going to like this if you have a larger iPhone, because basically what you can do is you can get rid of all of the apps up here, just get rid of them, or move them down to where they're easily accessible. So I'm going to show you a couple little tricks here though when we do this. That's the basics of how it works, but I'm going to show you a couple little tricks here. So now I'm going to go back into that jiggle mode. We run into a little bit of a problem. Let's say I did want to move mail down here. Watch what happens when I do that. It follows the old behavior. I still have an app up here. I don't want to have an app up here. In fact, what I would like to do is I would like to get rid of both of these apps here. I want to move them down. But anytime that I do that, we can see that it just moves the other apps up. So how can I do that? Well, this is the little trick, what you have to do. Basically, what you have to do is just create a blank spot. So I'm going to create a blank spot right down here. So I'm just going to drag the calendar and over there. Now what I do is I just take all of these and I move them down. So I'm just going to drag them down one by one. We basically have to do this one by one. And there may be other ways. It's kind of like that game where you have to go and shuffle things around. There may be other ways to do that, but basically this will work. So I'm just dragging them down one by one. Now we can see that we have our blank spot up here. So that's how we can move our apps. And as you can see, it can get a little bit tricky, but basically all you have to do is just move them one by one, and then you'll be able to move your apps anywhere you want on your home screen. The next new feature we're going to discuss is app icons. With iOS 18, you now have the option to choose between small and large app icons. Basically, what we're able to do is turn an app icon directly into a widget. That's essentially what we're doing. Let's see how we do this. Let's go back over to my iPhone. So let's just say that I wanted to turn the clock app here into a widget. I want to have a bigger clock there. Now, in the past, what I would have to do is go into the jiggly mode and go and add a widget and drag it on there. But now, watch what happens when I tap and hold on this icon. So I'm going to tap and hold on it. And you're going to see that we have, up towards the top here, four different options. The first one on the far left is our standard app icon. When I go over to the right, what we have here are different sizes. Basically, these are the different widgets. So I'm just going to tap on this one right down here. And when I do, you're going to see that that clock is going to get larger and it turns into a widget. Let's go ahead and do that with the calendar app. So we have the calendar app down here. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to move it over to another screen so we have a little bit more room so we can see what we're doing. So I tap and hold on it and then I just drag it over to the edge. We'll just go to a new blank screen here. And like I said, we can just place it anywhere we want. So I'm just going to place it up towards the top. So now I have that app icon there. Now let's go and take a look at the different sizes we can do with this. So I just tap and hold on it. And we have our first one here, which will make it a little bit larger. There it is. And like I said, it turns it into a widget. I tap and hold on it. Let's make it a little bit larger. Now we're going to go to this one here. And it's a little bit larger. And then if I tap and hold on it again, we go over to this one here. And now it's going to be the largest size. Now, being that this is a widget now, what we're able to do is edit that widget. So maybe this isn't showing the right information. We have different widgets that show different information. Well, we can edit this widget. So I just tap and hold on it, and you're going to see edit widget. Now, this is nothing new. We've always been able to edit the widget, but it really comes in handy when we can resize these app icons. So now I just tap on it, and then from here, I can go and set the different options for that particular widget. If I want to turn it back into an icon, just a standard icon, I can do that as well. I just tap and hold, and then we go over here. Now it is just a standard app icon. So that's how we can turn our app icons into widgets, or just basically make them larger. Another new feature with iOS 18 is the ability to lock and hide apps. Basically, what we're able to do is have an app require your Face ID to open it up, and depending on if it's a third-party app or not, we can also hide it. Let's see what I mean. Let's go back over to my iPhone. So I'm going to swipe over here. I have these two apps. These are two calendars. I have the Apple calendar here, and then I also have a Notion calendar here, a third-party app. Now, I don't want anybody that has my phone to be able to take a look at these. When it is, at least from what I can tell, when it is an Apple app, what we can do is we can just lock it. It's not going to remove it from the home screen. So let's just go ahead and see how we do that. So I just tap and hold on it. And then you're going to see the option to require Face ID. When I tap on this, what it's going to do is it's going to require the Face ID to open it up. So I just tap on it. And now if I were to hand my phone to anyone, what they would not be able to do is open up that app, because it requires Face ID. Now I would, because it is my face. I'm going to turn the phone away from me, and you're going to see that when I tap on it, it says Face ID required. But when I look at it, it opens up. So that's how we can lock an app. It still keeps it on the home screen here, though. But what I found is that with some apps, it seems to be third-party apps. I don't know if this is going to be consistent or not. But with third-party apps, what I can also do is hide them. So let's take a look at this app here. This is a third-party app. So I do the same thing, tap and hold. And then you're going to see require Face ID, just like before. But we're going to have another option here. What we're able to do is require the Face ID, which is exactly how the calendar app worked, or what I can do is I can hide and require the Face ID. What it's going to do is it's going to put it into a hidden folder, and the only way they can access that is with Face ID. The hidden folder is actually going to be in your app library. Let's see what I mean. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tap on that, and you're going to see that the app is now hidden. It is still on my iPhone. So how do I find it? I need to go to the app library. So now I just swipe over. And when I swipe up, you're going to see I have a new folder here called Hidden. And when I tap on it, I'm going to turn the phone away from me so it's not looking at me. When I tap on it, what it's going to do is require a Face ID. You're going to see that it's not doing anything. It requires a Face ID. But now, when I turn the phone towards me and I tap on it, I can see that app. And then I can also just tap on it to open it up. So in addition to locking an app, we can also hide it depending on where the app came from. Like I said, all of the apps that I've tried this with, it seems to be Apple apps, we keep on the home screen. But if it's a third-party app, it can go into this hidden folder here. I don't know if that's going to be consistent or if Apple's going to change that in an update, but that's basically the way it's working as I'm recording right now. But essentially what you can do now is you can just lock an app and even hide it possibly. Now, the last thing I want to show you is lock screen changes. When we're looking at my iPhone here, I'm going to lock my iPhone here. And when we're wake it back up, you're going to see that we have these two icons here. We have the camera icon, and then we have the flashlight icon. This is how it has always been on the lock screen. Well, now what we're able to do with iOS 18 is change these out. So let's say you use a different camera app. I like the Halid camera app. So what I would like to do is replace the camera app here with Halid. How can we do that? So then I can easily access Halid instead of the camera app from my lock screen. Well, we first have to go and edit the lock screen. So I'm looking at my lock screen here and I just tap and hold. And now I'm able to customize it. So we have to go and customize our lock screen. Now, when we customize it, you're going to see that we have the option when I tap on this one here. This is my actual lock screen. This is what my home screen is. We're not going to touch the home screen. All we're worried about is the lock screen. So I'm just going to go and tap on this one here. And you're going to see that what I'm able to do is remove that camera icon. You can see it has a little minus there. I can also remove the flashlight. And when I do, let's go ahead and tap on the camera. It turns into a plus. And now all I have to do is just go and select which app I want. So I'd be able to select Halid in here if I had Halid on my iPhone. And then I'd be able to open up that app instead of the camera app. So now we can customize what apps are available to us from the lock screen as well. So those are the major new features that we have with iOS 18 and the iPhone. We can place our app icons anywhere we want for the most part. I call it a flexible grid. We can resize our app icons, basically turn them into widgets. We can lock and hide apps, and then we can also change what apps are available on our lock screen. So those are the new features that we have available for our home screen and apps on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, and subscribe to my channel. It all helps. Here's a little bit about me and what I have to offer. I'm Dan Wasink. I've been creating easy-to-follow video tutorials for your Apple devices for over a decade. You can find these videos on YouTube. I have about 400 or over 400 of them on YouTube, but on my site, danstutorials.com, I have over 2,100 videos. I also host webinars and classes on a regular basis through my website, and I recently added an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius. So if you have a question, you can ask this AI assistant, and in a lot of cases, I dare say in most cases, it'll probably be able to help you. All this is included when you become a member of my site. Members get all of the videos ad-free. I take out all the ads. You get access to my classes and my webinars, and you get access to my AI assistant. But on top of all that, you are also helping support a small business. It's just me sitting in a corner office in my house recording these videos. So when you do become a member, just know that you're helping support a small business, as well as all of the other benefits. So I hope that you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.